configure our first template in DocuSign. So we will go over to the DocuSign Apps Launcher and we'll go to DocuSign Envelope Templates. Click New. Our first step is to name the template. And then we have to select the data source. So this is the record that you're going to put the DocuSign button on. So where do you want your user to be able to send the DocuSign envelope out for signature? We're going to use the opportunity in our example. Our first step is to upload a copy of our proposal. So we have that here. Then I'm going to rename this so that it's a little bit friendlier of a name. Okay, and then I'll click Next. Our next step is to add recipients. We will click Add Recipient, and then we can use a lookup field on the opportunity. We actually do have a primary contact lookup field, and you can also use your opportunity contact roles to filter from as well. So you can select opportunity contact roles, and then you can say, I only want the opportunity contact roles with a role of DocuSign signer to come in here. And then our template role is going to be signer one. And maybe you have a field on your opportunity contact role that lets the user decide who's signer one, who's signer two. So those are some of the more complex scenarios. The scenario that we're going to use here is that there's one signer, and we're going to pull that signer from the opportunity contact role related list. One thing to note, if you are configuring a custom object in DocuSign and you're initiating the DocuSign send from a custom object record, and then you have your contacts in a related object to that custom object, this related list will not show that custom object. This related list only supports opportunity contact roles and contract contact roles. As of about 30 days ago, we checked it out with DocuSign support and they confirmed that no other objects are supported there. We will set our action as needs to sign and we'll click Add. Now you can add additional recipients. So if you wanted to, maybe the primary contact on the opportunity, maybe you wanted them to receive a copy of this. You'll set the role as receives a copy. You'll click Add, and then you can assign a signing order as well. So first the person is going to sign the document, and then the second person is going to receive a copy. Then down here, you can set the subject line that you want the email to have when it goes to your customer or prospect. And we like to put in the name of the account that we're sending this proposal to. So we're gonna say proposal for, and then you can use field merges in here. It's hard to find this info in the documentation. So if you want to get the account's name, here is the syntax that you'll use for that particular value. Then you can set whatever you want the email message to have in there. And that all looks good, and we'll click Next. Here's where we're going to add our merge fields in. So you'll want to pull up your Word document that you are configuring to make sure that you account for all the fields that you need to create in here. So we have an account name, we need the phone, the address, primary contact, primary contact's email address, we have a proposal expiration date. So let's start configuring some of those. So we'll click Add Field, and then you give it a second and it'll bring up a field picker here. We want to pull over the account name. So we'll go to this first one that says account ID, account reference, give it a second. And then here's all the fields that exist on the account object. You'll select account name, and then you'll see here that DocuSign automatically drops the name of the field down here for you. I like what they do because they put the name of the object and then the name of the field after it. But I would add in op ACC account name, because this tells me that I went from the op to the account name. When you start having a lot of different field merges in DocuSign due to populating different documents that are initiated from the account or initiated from somewhere else, you need to be able to tell the difference between these fields easily from the list. Then over here, do we want to allow the person signing to edit this? Well, if their company name's not right, in this case, I do want them to be able to edit it. And then I want that to write back into Salesforce. Then this is a required field. If you didn't want them to be able to edit it, then you would just uncheck all of these and you would make it read only for the signer. Let's make it easy. Let's make everything read only in this scenario. You have more options down here. We're not going to get into any tooltips or anchor text. That'll be for a future DocuSign video. We'll click save, and then you'll see the field merge drop down here. We're going to add our next field, which is account phone. Then I'm going to make that, let's let them edit that one. I'll save that. Now you can see that the account phone is writing back and that the account name is read only. Next, we're going to put in the account address. So we'll select the account reference. And then we'll go to billing address. I'm going to make this read only. Click save. I'm going to add another field. This time, this is the primary contact. Like I said, I have a primary contact lookup to the contact object here. So I'll click that. Then that's going to bring up another dropdown. So the cool thing about DocuSign is you can go up to 4 levels away from your initial object. So it's really powerful because you can get data from just about anywhere. I'm going to use full name here. And then I'll change this to op primary contact full name. I'm going to make this read only and click save. Now I want to add in the primary contact's email address. I will select email. And I will name this op primary contact email. Make this read only. Next, I have a proposal expiration date. Now, this is a date field that exists directly on the opportunity. Well, those of you who already know this isn't going to work, hang tight. I want to show everybody else that this isn't going to work properly, and we'll show you how to solve for it. We'll make this read only. Next, we have a place for the total investment. So this is the opportunity amount field. I will make this one read only as well. And then we also have our op products. So we're going to go to the list that says opportunity product right here, opportunity line items. We'll select that. Now in our proposal, we're listing out the name of the service and then the cost. So how this translates to the fields on the opportunity product is we want to pull in the product name and then we want to pull in the product price. So you may have to do some digging to find this. We'll make it a little bit easy on you. If you use the opportunity product name, it takes the name of the opportunity and then concatenates it with the product name. And we don't want to do that. So we're going to go to the price book entry and we're just going to pull the product name because that's what we want. So we'll call this op price book entry product name. And this is read only. Next, we're going to add another field from the price book entry. We'll go to the op product, then price book entry, and then we want to to use, oh no, we want to use the total price. This field, the total price field, is on the op product. So we have a sales price and a list price on the op product. Or the total price. So the difference between these, list price is the price that is listed in your price book. The sales price is the price that you're going to offer per unit. So this is the unit price. And then the total price is the sales price times the quantity. So we actually want the total price here. So we'll call this op product total price. And this will be read only as well. Right, we have all of our field merges in, pretty sure. And then we'll click next. And here's our document. So we're gonna drag and drop our fields onto this document. All the fields that you just created are underneath this menu called Merge Fields. So you will drag and drop name here. And where's our phone? Down here. Then address, primary contact full name, primary contact email, proposal expiration date. Now down here in the opportunity contact roles, one thing to note here, this is not scalable, this meaning or dynamic, like this table is not gonna shrink and expand as you add more or less products. If you have that type of requirement, you need to have the DocuSign Gen product, because that will allow you to create tables that expand and contract depending on how many related items you have. If you're just starting out on DocuSign and you don't know if you need that, you can start with eSignature and see how it goes. Conga Composer is also another great solution that will allow you to put tables into your proposal, and it will expand and contract the table and show all of your related products as well, and it's dynamic. So those are your two different solutions for that. In this case, we usually only have like three products on our opportunities at most. And in this type of scenario, you may be able to get away with the solution that we're gonna show you. But if you have like, if you could have up to 10 products, then you're gonna want to make your cost of services table bigger here, so that you're gonna need to add in a place for each product that could exist. So you're gonna have to add in the product name 3 times. And if there's only one will show. If there's 3, 3 will show. But you have to have a row for each one. Now this first one, we'll click on this, and we're gonna click the Salesforce part in the sidebar here. And you see that it says Salesforce row 1. You also saw that I dragged and dropped each one from the side here. And that's because this will not configure properly if you copy and paste these fields here. I've tried that and it didn't work. For the amount, for the total price of each product, you will drag it 3 times from this side as well. Now, the first one should say 1, the second one should say 2, the third one should say 3. Just confirm that you see that. Same thing for your total price. You should see a 1, a 2, and then a 3. Now we're gonna line these up. DocuSign has a nice little easy way to line up your fields at the top here. And then you can also line up these rows. Everything looks better when it's lined up. All right, our op products are in. Now our op amount is our total investment. And then we also have a couple of other places down here where the company's name that we're doing business with should be pre-populated. And then we have more places over here so that their company name should be here. And now the rest of these are signer fields. So we're going to go to our standard fields picker, and this, we're going to drag and drop here to the signature. Now you can see that these are all yellow, and you can see that this corresponds to this list up here. So if you have more than one signer, the second one's usually teal. So make sure that you've selected who's supposed to sign here. So we're going to do all of the signer one fields, and I'll show you how to add in a signer two. We'll drag the title. We'll do the date and the name. Now you may have a certain font that you want to use here. You can update the fonts really easily if you highlight them all, and then you can go to formatting, and then you can change the fonts to be whatever you want all at once. It's a nice feature. Now each of these, you can see the configuration here. So anything that's yellow is going to be required. Anything that's white is read only. And then down here, we'll just come and we will edit these fields to format them in the same font. And then we will also do these, except you cannot configure the sign field merge. All right, so everything's in Calibri and these are all required. We will save and close this. Don't know why it's showing in Classic. Here on this section, we will be able to configure automatic reminders. You can say if you want to bug them every 2 days if they haven't signed it yet, that's up to you. You can identify when this envelope is going to expire. Here you can also set settings for your users. If you don't want them to be able to configure the recipients or add the documents or change anything, you can choose which settings you want here. And then here's where we identify how do we want the documents to come back into Salesforce if we do it all. If you do, you'll need to check this box. So this is going to make the files come back in, the documents come back into the files related list on the opportunity. You can choose if you want to combine all of the documents into one PDF, if there's more than one. So if you're sending out maybe a proposal and a W-9, or maybe there's multiple documents that you want to come back separately, maybe an MSA and an SOW, you would want to leave that unchecked. You can define what you want the file name to be, and then you can say that you do or you don't want to save the certificate of completion. So this is just the e-signature tracking history of what happened whenever the user signed the document. Down here, you can configure some updates that you want to happen. I really love this feature because it allows you to change the opportunity stages for your users, because they always forget to do that. So when they send out an envelope, we can say that we want to update the stage to negotiation review. And then when it comes back signed, maybe you want to update the stage to closed one. So those two actions will now happen based on these field updates, which is pretty cool. I will click next. Here's where you will configure a button. So we want to call this DocuSign proposal. And then I want to add it to my opportunity layout. I will click save and finish. And then let's go back to Lightning. Okay, I'm not sure what's happening with DocuSign here. Let's just refresh. Okay, and let's go to all. And now we see our proposal for services on the opportunity object. So this is what we just configured.